Mark Manson, the author of The Subtle Act of Not Giving a Fuck, says we approach life using different filters. What is wrong for you might be right to the next person, and that life in itself is an unending maze of problems that need continuous solving, and that the solutions we give to today's problems form the foundations for tomorrow's own problems. Hence, the title for this video, 8 Mistakes Ruining Your Life You Will Regret Later. 1. Comparing yourself to others. Avoid comparison at all costs, especially if it has a drain on your time, money, and effort. Even though comparison has been a key milestone in measuring progress for ages, if comparison pushes you to work harder and energizes you to take on newer challenges that will better your position in life, then it's healthy comparison. But if it fills you with negativity, bigotry, and jealousy about other people's successes, it's time for you to rethink and repurpose your energy and time into productive habits instead of making a fool out of yourself, time, and resources that you will regret later. 2. Disobedient to parents. It's common practice to find millennials running away from home and living on the streets on the account of parental disobedience, which sometimes is caused by abnormal aspirations, trying to force parents to give them a life their parents can't afford for themselves, talk less for their children. Some choose to live off a friend's couch because they are ashamed of their family situation and choose to live a fake life which is clearly above their means. We know that parents are not always right, but for the most part, they are always correct, and when they restrain you, they do so out of love and not out of hatred. 3. Living above your means. Comparing too much makes you prone to this mistake, because once you get started, it's very difficult to quit. According to the law of consistency by Robert Cialdini, when an individual starts behaving in a particular way, they want to continue in that direction no matter what. Once the going gets tougher and you no longer can afford your fake life, it is usually difficult to revert to your old lifestyle. As such, you may find yourself taking part in illegal ways of making quick cash in order to stay afloat and be in the spotlight. And anyone who tries to talk you out of this rat race is seen as an obstacle or is jealous of your new lifestyle. 4. Trying to impress people. Economics say the reason why we get trapped in the rat race is because we spend a lot of money on worthless items to impress people who don't care about us. The side effect of trying to impress people on social media is that you unknowingly invite depression and anxiety into your life because you entrust your well-being to the hands of a robot and on the opinions of strangers, only to discover in your old age that you wasted your youthfulness living for others instead of yourself. What a pity. 5. Forcing people to love you. You can take a horse to the stream, but you can't force it to drink water. In this case, it means that you can't force anyone to fall in love with you. Even if you sacrifice your chance for a better life for the sake of trying to adapt yourself to someone else's lifestyle as a way to impress them into falling in love with you, trying to change a person to suit your standard is a pure waste of time, money, and energy. See, all habits die hard, and the majority of people out there don't care about you. So why try so much to impress them? Those who make this mistake often find themselves single, beaten, unloved, and lonely in their old age, filled with the regret of not living a life of their own. 6. Not saving up. Most of the successful and renowned billionaires of our time started saving at a very tender age compared to the majority of you watching this video now. If you think otherwise, let me know when you started saving in the comment section below. Let's take the case of Warren Buffett, who started saving at the age of 7, and by age 13, he filed in his first tax return. It is no doubt that the coming of credit cards has made saving more difficult than before, but it is still not an excuse for you not to start saving. Although financial experts recommend that you save 10% of what you earn per month, a nickel, I say, is not too small to start a saving account with. Start saving now or regret later. 7. Not setting boundaries. Social scientist say man is a social animal with unlimited wants who hates to be restricted. The pitfall of having too much time in your 20s is that you tend to prioritize your time to activities that bring you immediate fun and comfort than on those that will bring you the most fun in the long run. Since you don't have any set boundaries on how you use your time, anybody who is ready to offer you a fun life or dangle a carrot in front of you can exploit your time to no bounds. It's only at a later age that you will come to the realization that you spent your youthfulness helping others to realize their dreams while you let your chance at a better life fade away. 8. Making yourself too available to bad company. Living above your means, trying to impress people, comparing with others, and having a lot of free time makes you prone to bad company. Our prisons are full today with good people who made very bad choices under the influence of bad company. Stay clear of bad friends, visionless friends, friends who are caught up in a celebrity web, and friends who chase after every piece of fashion. As the saying goes, show me your friends and I will tell you who you are. If the life you are living now is too easy with lots of fun, know that your 50s will be full of regret. And if you are 50 now and watching, don't think you are free. Your 70s will be the exact opposite of what you are living today if you don't plan for it as you did for your 50s when you were in your 20s. Live today like a slave, to live tomorrow like a king.